Hi.
I'm not going to lie, I've done all of this. I've just come from the glory shop.
Wait. Pippin's really fun. Welcome back to my channel. In this video, this is going to be our nursery decorating, getting organised video. More getting it together structurally and decorating and stuff. So it was currently an office and a junk room, a spare room, a salon. It's been everything before this. So quite looking forward to it being a nursery finally. So we thought we would make a start, as it's November 2020, we're in another lockdown. I am currently 19 weeks pregnant today. And yeah, we just thought we will utilise our weekends while there's no restaurants open, no shops to go to, and everything else to make a start and get it done. It's got to be done at some point, and rather than rushing it, that's the word. We thought we would do it bit by bit. So yeah, getting the prep work done, stripping it, filling the holes. We cleaned it out last weekend, took all the junk out in the office stuff. So yeah, that is what this video is going to be all about. Hi again, it is dishwasher. It is minus, well, next Saturday is the day we find out the gender of the baby, which is amazing. Can't wait. But today, we're in the nursery again, doing a bit more work. Last week, when I showed you, we were stripping the wallpaper, which is now all off. And today is a game of filling, pulling the plugs out that was holding shelves up before. So yeah, this is where we're at. Fill these holes, big holes. A blind for up there. Okay. We're hoping this is where the cot's gonna go. And these are like the colours we're gonna go for on this wall. And yes, we are gonna go for all of them. Starting from the bottom and doing like an ombre all the way up to the ceiling. And then we're gonna go for an off-white everywhere else, which we've undecided on yet. But yeah, it is coming together. Also, 20 weeks today.
Woo woo. We're filling for you. And then what you got?
The skills.
Look at that. And I want a bit all over the floor as well. Okay, so a little update. We've done a last bit of sanding on the ceilings and the walls. And we've just gone out and bought all the wood cladding. So I'm just about to start cutting and fixing that to that wall. Hopefully it'll look good. So yeah, that is sort of where we're at the moment.
I don't know how many days we've been working on this now. Not many. But the other day we finished the wood panelling. And I today am just going over the knots in the wood with knotting solution. So this is the wall, and obviously the darker bits, you can see, I've got gloves on, have already been dabbed with the knotting solution. And obviously the top part hasn't been done yet. To be fair, it doesn't actually look too much different. But I think it just stops the knots showing through in the paint. So we're so proud, like it looks so good. And then obviously, I don't know if I've told you this already, we're gonna do like an ombre color. So every four panels, the color will change from dark to light in like an orange type palette. And we're hoping that the wardrobes and drawers will go on this wall, and the cot will go on this wall, maybe a chair somewhere, I don't know. Mark's made a toy chest, which I can see going there, but who knows. We have got a plug socket there, so we'll probably put a TV up. We did have a TV up, but it was really old, so we just got rid of it. And then we've got this big wall as well that's as big as this one. We've got to get the blind put up. All the walls are going to be white other than this one. So yeah, that is how things are going so far. And then we've got to prime the wood to paint and then whitewash everywhere. And then we can get on to doing the colours on the wood, which I'm so excited about. The flooring's actually staying the same in here, but we've covered it over in cardboard. Just so it doesn't get damaged with the ladders and the tools and stuff that are up here all the time now. So yeah, that is how nursery, baby boy's nursery is going. Another day in the nursery. There's me. Mark is doing the undercoating on the wood paneling that we put up last week. I showed you the knotting solution that I also did in there. So yeah, this is the undercoat going on now. Now painting a clock and taping a clock. So that wall is now all undercoated with one undercoat. I am about to start white painting that wall. Mark's going to be doing the ceiling, and then we'll be starting on this wall next. Hopefully we can get another layer of undercoat on here. Possibly fill in these little pinholes as well, where we fixed them last week, before hopefully maybe tomorrow we can start getting some colour on here. It's very exciting.
Very, very exciting.
White paint is a go-go. So ceiling has had one coat, Mark's just finishing that off. This wall is now white. Well, it's one coat again. This wall is now white, one coat. It's coming together. We are losing light, however. I mean, to turn the lights off. But it is very... Ooh, I've been painting up. So yeah, it's coming together. We're very pleased. Feels like it's moving very fast now because the walls are going to stay white. And other than the wood panel wall, which is going to be the ombre, everything else is staying white. So this is practically almost done now, which is crazy. Do you think?
Yeah, I think we didn't get everything in this place, to be honest.
Yeah, we've gained a day, really.
Gained a day, yeah.
I mean, we haven't put the Christmas tree up yet, but what's the date today? 5th of December. So I'm about to be 22 weeks pregnant tomorrow. Nice angle. So yeah, it is coming along. Wonder when it'll be done. Wonder when this video will go out and I'm sitting here going, oh, it's November, it's December. And I'll probably put this out in like February. We'll see. The lighting is always terrible when I come to film. We are about to start putting the actual colours on the wall. We've finally finished all the white paint. So I'm just going to pamper here because I've got no shoes on. So that's exciting. So on this wall is the wood panels. Four wood panels, apart from the top one, which is like 4.5. Are going to be per colour. These are the colours. So we're going to start from the top so that it doesn't drip onto the dark colours at the bottom. How are you feeling about getting that colour on?
Real, real nervous. Because we've been able to just do like pretty rough slapdash.
With the white, because it's white everywhere, isn't it? I mean, look at this floor.
Painting myself more than I painted the walls.
I mean, look at my face.
So yeah, this is. I'm not looking forward to cutting in the ceiling and the sides.
Yeah.
The walls. So that's.
Well, you can reach the top better than me. So as soon as you've done that,
it's making me look real ginger.
Come
well, I mean, that. I am slightly ginger, but.
There we go. So we're gonna put it on like a bit of a time lapse. So you can see the colour going on.
Yeah, it made me look like I'm doing it a lot quicker than I actually am.
It'll probably take 3 days to do this. Decided to go for alternating colours today just to give the in-between colours enough time to dry before we go in to do the last three. But I'm so happy with the way it looks. Obviously that's the lightest one at the top. I love them, do you?
Yeah, I'm really pleased. Really pleased. I think it'll look even better when they, like you say, the colours in between go.
Yeah, once the, because it'll split them up more, because it's supposed to be like an ombre at the moment. It's quite a...
Harsh
lines. I mean, it's not going to be too flowy, but it'll be more flowy than this. But it's very exciting. This is the bit we've been most excited to do, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. I think it's just because it's going to be the bit that makes the room different.
Yeah.
It's going to change the way it looks.
Because as soon as we've done this, and we've put the plugs back on, we can just tidy up really and take the cardboard up, can't we?
We've got a skirting to
do. Oh, yeah. Skirting architrave. Skirting architrave and door, and then we've got to put the blind on the skylight as well, which we've now ordered. Because you don't want to have the ladders on the floor, do you?
No.
So Mel will leave all that down.
Yeah.
But very exciting. Good day's work there, good weekend's work.
Yeah,
all and most of the painting done. Speed this up.
I'm pleased.
Yeah, it looks good. It wasn't too difficult to put up either, was it?
No, it's four screws. You just gotta feed the runners into these two channels. That would seem to be the most difficult bit. But it was really easy to put up. It would have been easier if I wasn't at such a height. And then you have to pair it as well. Got one of these little things you get with the phone.
Oh, yeah.
You gotta press reset and then pair it with the remote.
And also I am on second coat duty on the wall. So yeah, hopefully all this will be done this weekend. And then we've picked up some white satin wood. Did we go satin wood or did we go eggshell? For round the skirting boards and door architrave frames and stuff. So yeah, all being well, that will all get done this weekend and the cardboard can come up and we can see what it actually looks like with the actual flooring.
This is me for the weekend now. I'm just going to keep playing with this up and down.
We've run out of juice, there's no sun. First coat of gloss has gone on the skirting board. We have removed the paint, we've moved all the rubbish, we've moved the ladders out of the way. This wall is complete, which I'm so thrilled with. And we're literally just about to get the cardboard up now too. first time I'm going to see the room, more or less, as it's going to be. Which is on the nursery journey, building the cot. We went for the Sniglar, is it Sniglar from IKEA?
Sniglar.
And literally, it is the cheapest one that they do, but it is in like a literally a really nice wood. Literally what we wanted for this room. It's gonna go really nicely against this wall. Very excited to see that put together. I'm gonna tell you that I love you 100 times a day, yeah. You'll get tired of my voice. That's how much I'm gonna tell you that I'll miss you. I'll miss you if you go. Yes, I'm gonna let you know just how much I tell your mama. I tell your papa too. I'm gonna let everyone know about my love. So I really hope you love me. Tell you that I need you. I need you every day. Yeah. You'll get weary of my touch. That's how much I'm gonna tell you that I want you. I wanna let you know. Oh, you're the only one for me. No one else. I'm gonna shout it out. Yeah. Up on the February, and it is all complete. It's been almost done for quite a while now, and we're so pleased with it. I'm going to link as many things as I can in the description box below, but come over to my Instagram and I will be doing a full nursery tour and tagging everybody where everything's from in my stories, and I'll be saving that to a highlight as well. So if you haven't seen it, get over to my Instagram and come and check that out. I am now 32 weeks and 4 days pregnant, which is just madness. I've just literally took all the prams out of this room because this is where I've been hoarding them. If you've watched my last video, the egg tube unboxing and the car seat unboxing and all the other bits we've got. But yeah, we are so pleased. These the storage crates underneath are perfect for extra storage. We decided against a wardrobe in the end and just went floating drawers. And then this amazing shelf from Pine and Pear with a slight hanging rail where we can just hang our favourite bits on. What else? We didn't go for a changing table in the end. We decided while he's little, we could just do it on there and then he'll probably just be changed on the floor and stuff. This is our sewing chair. So that just moves like that. This is the cot all built. I did get a sleepy head as well, in the bronzed cheetah pattern, which kind of just goes amazingly with the room. Those star bunting, that's from Zara. Big Ken from patch plants. Rugs from Zara. Chair is my own, I've had for quite a long time. You will have seen it in the first clip with Miko, the cat sitting on it, and I've had it recovered. Those poofs are from IKEA. This is the toy chest that Mark made, bookshelves from IKEA. That flag poster thing is from P&Co. And then everything else is really from just like individual places and independent shops and stuff. So yes, love them all. I will be tagging everybody on Instagram, so make sure you do come over and check that out. I'm sorry that it took so long to get this video together, but I'm so glad I finally got it out for you to see how it all did come together. And even for me, just watching it back, it's just amazing to see the transformation of this wall, and we just love it so much. It's exactly what we wanted. Thank you so much for watching. It won't be long until he's here now, which is absolutely crazy. If there's anything you want me to talk about or make any videos on, make sure you leave a comment below. Make sure you leave a thumbs up on this post. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel. And I will definitely, we will see you on the next one.